Why is it that today people are still in the church and surely they are sinning? Amen. There are certain things that we are hearing, certain testimony that you are hearing, that somebody is in the church and he is a bishop or a pastor, but he is sleeping with women there, and he still come in the pulpit and he still prophesy, he still teach the Bible. Praise Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When he's still doing all those nonsense, all those abominations, and you wonder, oh God, where is the conviction? That means it is dead. It is dead like a reprobate. Cannot feel anything, cannot hear anything. And they do not feel even ashamed of what they are doing. The same thing that is happening, that people are doing, that is staying in the church. They are walking in nakedness. There is a lot of evil. But they don't mind. And you wonder, where is the conscience? Where is the conviction? I tell you, if you don't have the conviction as a Christian, you are a dead Christian. And a dead Christian is as better, like a reprobate. They can still joke there, they can still drink alcohol, smoke, and still go to church like normal. Because there is nothing that convicts them that what you are doing is wrong. They are there. When it comes to praise and worship, they will praise and worship. But when it comes to drinking, they will drink. When they come to do evil, they sin. But when they come to church, they will do like in the church. But outside, they are like the world.
Yes.
And what? Where is that conviction? The conscience. Because when somebody is wrong, he should know he's wrong. Animals, they have those convictions.
Yes.
But humans, they don't have those convictions.
Sure.
We need to be convicted. We need to be guilty of our sin.
Yes.
Fornication, lying, evil thought, lusting, pride, envy, jealousy, unforgiving, the conviction of the heart will lead us to repentance.
Yes.
But will not lead us to the judgment.
Amen.
But to repentance. Because when you are not led into repentance, you will be led into judgment.
True.
But when you are led into the conviction, you start repenting one by one. And say, God, I know I am not pure before you. I am not coming here because I am pure. Lord, I come here so that you may cleanse me, so that you may purify me. For sure, God will cleanse you. He will purify you.